Hello, my name is Kathy Wilson. I'm a professor of cell biology at Johns Hopkins School of Medicine. My lab studies the cell nucleus, mothership of the human genome. It's really important for many diseases, but still a mystery. Today, I'm going to use the toy box to show you how we're studying the nucleus and why it's important. Every cell has a nucleus. This is where our chromosomes are protected and organized. The nucleus is like the world's best organized closet. Only instead of clothes, the nucleus needs to organize genes, meaning DNA. So let me show you what a piece of DNA looks like. It looks like a fuzzy worm. It's, in this case, yellow. And let's say that this gene codes for proteins that are needed in all cell types. Every cell in your body needs to make a lot of proteins just for the structure of the cell. And so there are a lot of these all-purpose genes, the yellow fuzzy worms. But we also have a lot of very special cell types. We have skin cells. We have heart cells. We have brain cells. And the genes that code for the skin proteins and the heart proteins and the brain proteins are very different from each other. And you want those proteins only to be on, to be expressed in the right kind of cell, and to be off, not expressed in the other cell types. The reality is that these genes are all strung together, making very long strings of DNA with all these genes end to end. And you can't fit these in a closet anymore. They're just too big. You can't keep them separate and say, you're closed, you're open. It doesn't work. So the nucleus has figured out an awesome way to solve this problem. So how does the nucleus do this? I'm going to use another toy to show you that. Move our toy box aside and bring in my favorite toy. So this is the best way to think about nuclear structure. It's this toy and these different colors represent filaments. They're like ropes, strong ropes, formed by proteins called lamins. And they are connected to other proteins, but they form a really important structure. People used to call it the nuclear matrix. And it can expand, and it needs to, as a cell, you know, doubles its DNA when it's replicating and growing. But normally it's kind of in this crouched position. And that's because cells they get pushed and pulled. And the nucleus protects the genome by being in this position it can be pushed and it springs back. It can hold its shape, but it's flexible. And this is really important for cells to just survive and protect. So the tricky part here is that I'm going to be showing you how the nucleus organizes these different genes. So the way it does it, there are a lot of proteins that I'm not showing you. They're in the first blanket, the first membrane. They're embedded in that membrane and they kind of dangle down like my fingers. And they bind to the lamins and they also can bind to chromosomes. So let's see if I can do this. We're going to make, what kind of cell should we make? Let's make a brain, a neuron cell. So all the DNA in here that's not blue is going to be tied up and organized at this nuclear lamina structure. Okay, so this is how you organize the DNA, the genes in the nuclear closet. You do this. Okay, so now the genes that are off are all associating with the lamin network and with the membrane proteins that you can't see here. And the genes, the fuzzy worms that are dangling down, they're loose and accessible. These are the genes that can be turned on and they code for RNA that makes proteins. And so this nucleus is a brain cell. It's the nucleus of a brain cell and it's making brain stuff, okay? But as you can see, you can pack a lot of DNA into a small space here. So this is a super good closet. Only the genes that need to be expressed are looping in. all the other genes, tightly packed and off. And it's all regulatable. You can change this. If you're in a different cell type, you loop up the brain genes. Let's say you want to be a skin cell. You loop up all the other genes, and so eventually, all the green skin genes are the ones that are dangling and on. This is how it's supposed to be. But my lab is studying how, for example, if you're a diabetic, sometimes these proteins don't behave the way they should, and in particular, one of these lamins, lamin A, may not be able to hold on to the genes the way it's supposed to. And a lot of human genetics is now realizing that there are mutations. A lot of people have inherited mutations in these kinds of proteins that can cause them to have heart problems or fat tissue problems, brain problems. And so it's really important to understand the nuts and bolts of this structure, including a lot of proteins that haven't even yet been identified. The more we understand this structure, the better we can personalize medicine. And so that people understand their individual risk for diseases like muscular dystrophy, heart disease, aging, accelerated aging, and type 2 diabetes. And it's really exciting to be part of this.